Hello students, in this tutorial we will learn about the operator precedence parser. So first of all, understand what operator precedence parser are doing. This type of parser reads and understands an operator precedence grammar. So whatever operators are present in the given grammar, that will be scanned and that will be interpreted by such type of parser, and based on that the parsing tree will be generated. So the main thing on which these parsers are working is nothing but your operator precedence grammar. So let us understand what this type of grammar is called as. So operator precedence grammar, all operator grammar is nothing but a grammar that will be used to define the mathematical operators. That means in what way operator should appear while creating the parsing, that will be decided by such type of grammar. So the operator grammar has two special properties. Number one, that there should not be presence of epsilon in the production rule. That means on the right hand side of a given grammar there should not be epsilon symbol. Secondly, there should not be a production rule which will contain two non-terminal adjacent to each other. That means two non-terminals or two variables should not be connected to each other in a given production rule. So by considering these two rules, I have given one example over here. Such type of grammar where e tends to e plus e or e product e or id. That means e and e are the two non-terminals. They are not adjacent to each other just because they are separated with sign plus. Here in the second production rule also they are separated with sign star, and id is a terminal symbol. So let us understand what type of grammar is called as is not called as operator grammar. So in this given grammar you can observe S tends to SAS. Here S is a non-terminal, A is also non-terminal, and S is also non-terminal. So such type of production rule is present, then such a grammar is not called as operator precedence grammar. So what we have to do, we will convert such grammar into an operator precedence grammar. So simply replace the productions created by the A into the S productions and you will get a grammar called as operator grammar. So replace the A productions into the S, you will obtain such type of productions where SBS, here S and S are the non-terminals but they are not adjacent to each other since B is in between both of them. So we have seen a grammar which is not a operator grammar, but we have converted that into an operator type of grammar. Here is also one example where E tends to EAE. So by looking at this particular production rule, you can easily come to know that this is not an operator grammar. So what we can do, check out the second production given by A. So A tends to different types of operators. So what we can do, we can replace value of A into this particular production rule and we will convert a non-operator grammar into an operator grammar. So once we replace A value into such type of grammar, we will obtain this type of E productions. So in this way we have converted this grammar which is not an operator grammar, and it is get converted by replacing values of A into the existing one, we will get a grammar which is an operator grammar. So now we will see how we can design operator precedence parser. We are following two steps while designing the operator precedence parser. First of all, we need to define the precedence relation between the terminal symbols. That means whichever operators or the terminal symbols present, we have to find out the precedence relation. In this grammar you can observe we have the terminal symbols like id, then plus, minus, multiplication, division and power of. So this will be called as terminal symbols. So what we have to do, first of all find out the relationship between these terminal symbols with respect to precedence of them. After finding it, we will construct the operator precedence table. So define the relationship between the terminal symbol, and based on that relationship we have to construct the table. So while defining the precedence relationship, again three major rules we have to follow. First one is define the precedence notation, that is less than, greater than, equal to. Then define which terminal is having highest and which terminal is having lowest precedence. And lastly, in case of similar terminals, find out the associativity. So rule number one, that we have to define the precedence notation for the precedence relationship. So find out, suppose we have two terminal symbols A and B. If precedence of B is higher than precedence of A, then we can define this relationship as A less than B, because B has higher precedence over A. If precedence of B is similar to precedence of A, then we will define relationship as A equal to B. And lastly, if precedence of B is lower than precedence of A, then the relationship that we can define is A greater than B. So here in rule number one, we have decided the notations. So which notation? Less than, equal to, and greater than. Here A has less precedence than B, A has precedence equal to B, and A has precedence greater than B. Vice versa you can read. In the second rule, we will define which one is having highest precedence and which one is having lowest precedence. So it is considered that the identifier as a terminal symbol will be given as higher precedence than any other symbol or any other operator, and dollar symbol will be given as the lowest precedence. So in rule 2, we define which terminal is having highest precedence and which one is having lowest precedence. So please keep in mind, identifier will be having higher precedence and dollar will be having lowest precedence. In the rule number 3, we will define the associativity. So if two operators are having same precedence, then we have to check their associativity. For an example, if plus and plus are appearing in a given input string, then left side plus will be executed first, then the right side one. So it is going from left to right. So by considering the associativity, that is left to right, we will give the precedence. So left one plus symbol is having higher precedence than the rightmost plus symbol. So we will see in detail during the example discussion. So let us consider a given grammar E tends to E plus E, E product E, and the ID. So just list down what terminals we have. So create a table. This is called as operator precedence table. So create a table with the terminal symbols. So I have created a table consisting the terminal symbols as ID plus star and the dollar. Similarly, we will create the same columns with the terminal symbols. So now find out which two operators are having precedence over each other, or equal to each other, or less than. So consider ID and ID. So while defining the relationship, I am going from row value to the column value, and it is also treated as left to right. So this ID are coming to each other, that means left ID and right ID. Usually you can see no two identifiers are coming in. We have seen the C language syntax where we cannot write variable as int a b. So it is always int a comma int b. So two identifiers cannot be connected to each other. That is why ID doesn't have any precedence. So this is not possible. Then we will see ID and plus. So as you can see, the rule number 2, where we define that the identifier is always given higher precedence than any other symbol. So considering this rule, ID is having higher precedence than plus, ID is having higher precedence than the star, and ID is having higher precedence than the dollar. So in this way we have defined the notation for terminal symbol id. So go for the plus now. So plus and id. So as we know that id is having higher precedence, so plus has less precedence over the id. Plus and plus. Now check out the rule number 3, where we have talked about the associativity. So this plus appears before this particular plus. So left to right associativity goes, left terminal to right terminal. So left terminal is having higher precedence than the right side wala terminal. So this plus is having higher precedence than the right plus. So plus and star. So multiplication gets executed before the plus, so having less precedence over the multiplication operation. And plus and dollar, always plus will be the highest precedence than the dollar. You can remember that dollar has the lowest precedence, so all the column values of dollar are less than symbol. Then next it is for the multiplication operator. So star and id, id has the highest, so star is less than id. Star and plus, star is always greater than plus. Star and star, again the what we can say, it is associativity. So left gets executed first, so left has greater precedence over the right. So star star, find out the associativity, that is left to right. So this star is greater than the second star. And star and dollar, always star is greater. Then dollar and id, dollar has the lowest precedence, so all the dollar row value will be less. And dollar and dollar, again we will see that left dollar is having higher precedence over the right dollar. So in what way we can proceed with the operator precedence parser? The algorithm is given to you. You will have an input as input string, let us say W, and a table of precedence relationship. So you will be having grammar, you will be having precedence table, and an input string will be given to you, which will be asked to parse that string against this grammar by using the precedence table. So input string will be given to you and table of precedence relationship will be there. Output of parser will be, it will be a well form with a placeholder non-terminal E labeling all interior nodes, otherwise an error indication. That means after applying the parsing algorithm we will get a non-terminal E. As you can see, this is bottom-up type of parsing. That means we will start from input string and we will derive the starting symbol. So we need to obtain this E non-terminal, that will be the ultimate output. And method will be, we will use a stack data structure which will contain dollar as its top of stack, an input buffer with string and which is ending with the dollar. So please keep in mind, you require two data structure, stack and second one is input buffer. Stack contains the dollar as its top value and an input buffer containing the string ending with the dollar. So let us understand the algorithm. Only two checks you have to understand and you need to remember is that we are going to compare the top of stack and the input symbol. We will compare top of stack and input symbol. So first of all, set your input pointer which will point to the first symbol of given string, and we have to repeat the steps. First of all, dollar will be on the top of stack and input is pointing to dollar, then return. That means once you get dollar as the stack content and input symbol will be dollar, that means dollar of stack and dollar of input string, then your string is correctly passed. You are simply returning out of the algorithm. If not so, then let us begin with what, see what you have on the top of stack. Let us say A is the symbol on the top of stack. Compare this A with the symbol B, which is nothing but pointed by input pointer, that is input string symbol. So compare A, which is top of stack, and compare B, which is symbol pointed by input pointer. So possibility are top of stack content may be having less precedence than the input string content, or top of stack content may be equal to input string content, or top of stack may be having higher precedence over the input string content. So only three possibilities are there, and based on that we have to consider the steps. So if top of stack having less precedence over the input symbol, or top of stack equal to the having equal precedence with respect to the input symbol, then simply push the input symbol onto the stack and increment the pointer, that is point to the next symbol. If top of stack is having greater precedence than the input symbol, then apply the reduction operation. That means what? Remove or pop this A from the stack and just compare whichever top of stack is present with the B. So in this way we will proceed by considering only less than, equal to and greater than relationship and apply the respective step. If it is less precedence, then push. If having greater precedence, pop. So only two operations we will perform on this stack. So let us consider what I have written here. You are given with a grammar E tends to E plus E, E star E and ID, and you will parse a string ID plus ID into ID. So first thing you need to do is what? Convert this given string into the input expression, that is ID plus ID into ID, and at the end append the dollar. So I am having the input string, I am having the grammar. Now I have designed my precedence table. I have listed some of the relationship: ID having greater precedence over plus, left plus greater than right plus, left multiplication greater than right multiplication. So let us start with this particular example. So in the step 1, consider the table. Keep this table always for your reference. The parse string is ID plus ID into ID and dollar. I hope this is visible to you. In the step 1, define the stack. So I have defined the stack. The top of stack will be dollar and end of string will be the dollar. In step 2, I will compare the top of stack and first input symbol, that is ID. Compare top of stack, that is dollar, and first input symbol, that is ID. So compare the dollar and ID. So I am highlighting this ID, which is nothing but current input symbol. So compare dollar and ID. So compare dollar and ID. Compare stack content and input content. The row are nothing but the stack content and columns are nothing but the input string contents. So dollar and ID. So dollar has less precedence over ID. Dollar has less precedence over ID. Hence we will push ID onto the stack. So dollar has less precedence than ID. We will push ID onto the stack. So ID got pushed onto the stack and we will increment the pointer. So pointer will point to the plus symbol. Go to the next step. So in the next step we will compare ID and the next input symbol, that is plus. Compare top of stack and the plus. So compare ID and plus. Compare ID and plus. So compare ID and plus. ID is greater than plus. So when you have such type of relationship, when you have top of stack greater than the input symbol, we are popping the top of stack. So ID is popped. So ID is popped and stack will remain like this. So now top of stack will be dollar and pointer is not moved. Keep in mind, when you are applying a reduce operation or pop operation, pointer is not moved. You will keep pointer pointing to the plus symbol. And when you pop the ID, that ID is nothing but your symbol E. So let us move to the next step. In the step number 4, you will compare dollar and the plus. So compare dollar and plus. So So dollar has less precedence than plus, so plus will get pushed. So dollar and plus is compared, so dollar found to be lesser than the plus, hence we will push it. Once push operation is applied, increment the pointer. So now pointer will point to the ID. So stack contents are dollar and plus. In the step 5, we will compare top of stack, that is plus, and the next input symbol, that is ID. So compare top of stack plus with the next input symbol ID. So plus and ID, plus and ID is compared. It is found that plus has less precedence over the ID. So we will push that ID. So ID is pushed into the stack and we will increment the pointer. So now pointer will point to the star and top of stack will be the ID. The step 6, we will compare top of stack, that is ID, and we will compare top of stack, that is ID, with the input symbol, that is multiplication sign. So ID and star, ID and star, ID is greater than star, so we will pop the ID first of all. So ID is pop, so stack will be dollar and plus, and we will keep pointer pointing to the star. So once we remove the ID, pop the ID, so ID, first ID, it is representing E, second ID is now representing the second symbol E. So in this way, first operator, that is plus, is evaluated. Now in the step number 7, we will compare the current top of stack, that is plus, and the current input symbol, that is star. So compare plus and star. So plus and star is compared. So plus and star, so we will see plus is less than star, hence we will push star onto the stack and we will increment the pointer. So now pointer will point to the ID symbol and stack will be having top, is nothing but your multiplication sign. In the step number 8, we will compare star with the ID. Compare star with the ID. So top of stack star and the current input symbol is ID. So star and ID is compared. It is found that star is less than ID. Star and ID, star is less than ID. So we will push ID onto the top of stack and increment the pointer. So pointer will point now to the dollar sign. In the step number 9, compare ID and the dollar. So compare ID and the dollar. Dollar has the lowest precedence, so ID is greater than dollar. We will pop the ID and keep pointer on the dollar only. So top of stack now become the multiplication. In the next step, we will compare multiplication and dollar. So in the step 10, the comparison is made between multiplication operator and dollar operator. So multiplication is greater than the dollar, so we will pop that multiplication also and we will keep pointer pointing to the dollar. So stack contents are dollar and plus. So here you can observe we have ID, ID, multiplication and ID. So first operator that is popped out is multiplication before plus. So E multiplied by E, this operation will happen first. In the step 11, we will compare top of stack, that is plus, with the dollar. So plus found to be greater than the dollar, hence we will pop the plus. So when you pop the plus out, you can observe in the previous operation E multiplied by E is happening, which can be replaced by E. Now this ID is coming, so E plus E is nothing but again E. In the step 12, you can see when plus is popped out, the stack is pointing to dollar and input pointer is pointing to dollar. So when you compare dollar and dollar, okay, that means what we have to return, both are equal. So string is successfully passed and the parser is accepting the string. So in this way you will check whether the given input string is passed by the parser or not. Okay, so please remember the steps. First of all, see the grammar given to you. If it is not an operator precedence grammar, convert it. After converting, find out the terminals and based on that terminals define their precedence table, and after having precedence table, take the input string and see with the help of stack and input buffer whether that given string is passed or not. simply apply push operation and pop operation based on greater than and less than conditions respectively. By considering this, I expect that you will solve this example where the input string is slightly changed. It is id plus id plus id followed by the dollar. So just try this input string for the same precedence table. Now look at the second example of operator precedence parser. Here you can observe the grammar is given and having various terminal symbols, and input string is given to you is id into open parenthesis id raised to id close parenthesis minus id divided by id, and you will add the dollar over here. So the precedence relation table is already shared with you. You can also try this example. The problem here, you can observe that when we have four terminals, we need to store their respective 16 cell values. For four terminals we have 16 cell values. Here we have 3 plus 3 plus 3 3 plus 3 plus 3 9 terminal symbols are there. So we also need to store these with 81 values. You can observe many possibilities are there. So the size is the important concern when you have this operator precedence table. So some of the disadvantage of having precedence table is size of the table requires the comparison big O of n raised to 2 n square, and that will lead to the memory issue. So what we can do, the operator precedence parser is a design in a such way that it will not store this precedence table with relationship. Instead, it will use some of the integer values. What it does, it will not store the precedence table consisting the relationship. Instead, it will keep the integer values stored in the table form, tabular form. Okay, how we will see. There will be simple numerical comparisons that will be used over the integer values stored in the table. So what we are going to have in order to store the integers, we will have the precedence functions that will hold or that will evaluate the integer value against the terminal symbols. So we will see how these precedence functions will be created. So some steps are there to construct the precedence function. These precedence functions are nothing but a kind of graph data structure. To be precise, it will be a directed graph where you will create a relationship between the left operator and right operator, or we can say we will have two functions for left and right, that is rows and columns. The rows will be represented by f function, whereas right functions, right symbols will be represented by the g function. So we will have f of a, that is f of terminal a, and g of terminal b. So in this way we will form a relationship. Also we will see whether f of a is greater than g of b or f of a is less than g of b or not. If it is so, then we will follow a directed way, or we will create a directed edge between f of a and g of b. So just consider your precedence relation table and simply use these directions. Okay, so this will be your f of terminals and the column will be your g of terminals. When I am going from f of a to g of b, I will look at the relationship. So it will be like this. That means f of a is greater than g of b. I have listed here. So if you have this symbol, so f of a is greater than g of b. If it is in a reverse direction, that means if you observe, this is like, okay, here I can say that g of b, that is star, is greater than f of a, that is plus. So g of star is greater than f of plus. In this way we can map. So simply consider the direction of arrow, which one is greater and which one is less than, you can easily find out. So based on that we have created a directed graph, such is the graph data structure we have created. Okay, so find out in what way we have created. Just look at the procedure. So FID will not go to FID. FID is greater than the G plus. So I am going from FID to G plus. FID and star. So FID is greater than G star. So FID is greater than G star have the directed edge. FID is greater than dollar. So FID is greater than the G dollar. FID is greater than the G dollar. So in this way we have created the directed graph between the nodes. Similarly, you can create for GID, G plus, G star and G dollar. Please keep in mind, you will create such directed graph consisting FID, F plus, F star and F dollar. Similarly for GID, G plus, G dollar, G star and G dollar. So in this way, directions will be marked when you have only greater than relationship. So simple, randomly I am taking, let us say F star we will take. So F star and ID, there will not be any relationship. F star and GID, we cannot go. F star and GID, GID is greater. So F star and G plus, F star and G plus, I can go F star and G plus because F star is greater than G plus. Similarly, F star and G star. So left is greater than right. So F star to G star, we can easily go. So F star to G star, there is a directed edge. So in this way, such directed graph is created. So next, after creating the graph, what we will do? We will find the longest path that will be taken by FID and GID. Okay? Because ultimately ID represents the symbol, non-terminal symbol, that is E. So find out the longest path taken by FID and longest path taken by GID. So FID's longest path will be, just consider the longest path up to the dollar sign. So it will be, I am going from FID to G star, then G star to F plus, then F plus to G plus and G plus to F dollar. So in this way we have obtained the path from FID to F dollar. Similarly for GID, we'll follow a path, let us say GID to F star, F star to G star, then G star to F plus is possible, F plus to G plus is possible and G plus to F dollar is possible. So in this way the path taken by FID and GID are created. So let us understand the final table. This is called as precedence function table. So in what way we will create this? So just look at the symbols. So F and G are the functions we mark and the common terminal symbols are listed in the column. So it will be F of plus, F of star, F of ID and F of dollar. Similarly, G of plus, G of star, G of ID and G of dollar. So let us compute their numerical values. Here we are simply replacing the terminal symbols relationship with the help of some integer value or numerical values. So let us consider the F of plus. So F of plus is appearing here. After that we have g plus and f dollar. Only two steps we have to take. So value of f of plus will be 2. Secondly, f star. So consider the f star. We obtain the f star here. After f star we have path computation, which will be 1, 2, 3 and 4. So f star will be 4. Then fid. After fid we have path computation up to 1, 2, 3 and 4. So fid value will be 4. And lastly f dollar. So f dollar and like this dollar symbol, that is the end symbols, we are not actually computing. After f dollar we don't have anything, so it will be marked as null. Okay, then the g plus we will computing. After g plus we have f dollar, after g plus we have f dollar, so value will be 1. Then the g star will be 1, 2 and 3. So g star will be 1, 2, 3. Then the gid. So after gid 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So gid will be 5. So in this way the respective terminal symbols of left and right side are represented with the help of some numerical values, integer values. So let us apply some comparison between them. So as we discussed that the f plus is greater than right plus, f plus is greater than g plus. F indicates left and g indicates right. So if we have two operators in the relationship, that is id plus id plus id, so left plus will get evaluated first. You can observe this left plus having higher precedence than the right plus, that is g plus. Similarly, if we compare f star and gid, f star and gid, so as we all know that id has the highest precedence, so f star, that is 4, and gid will be 5. In this way it will get evaluated. So sir, this will be the last step where we will find the precedence function for the given grammar for its respective inputs. Then just simply consider the grammar. From that grammar create the precedence relation table, and from the precedence relation table find out the precedence function. So in this way the operator precedence grammar works. In the next tutorial we will start with the LR parsers, that is the very important topic in which we will first of all consider the simple LR parser. Please subscribe to my channel, that will give you the notifications once I add any new video. Comment for any query, any doubt, difficulty. Thank you so much.